And in the interim, you made a comment at the end of your talk today about it was, we need to take our consciousness back into our own hands.
I do feel very, very strongly that we do.
It's been co-opted by the media and by everything
else.
Well,
yes. First of all, on the input side, Western civilization has taken control of the consciousness of billions of people through the medium of television, projecting the ethic of Western culture, the consumerist, materialist ethic, is beamed at us 24 hours a day on our TV channels. And secondly, on the other side, Western culture has criminalized and demonized all experiences involving altered states of consciousness and any substances that put us into an altered state of consciousness. And this is clearly a war over consciousness that's going on. It's clear that our societies have an investment in preventing us from exploring where altered states of consciousness will lead us. Perhaps there's a deep fear that if we do explore those altered states of consciousness, we will not accept the power structures and the fairy tale illusion of material wealth that we're all brought up to pursue as though that's the only thing to existence. Suppose that the ancient Egyptians and other cultures like that were right. Suppose they were right, that it's really vital, absolutely vital, for us and for our eternal destiny what we do in this life. And then consider the predicament of billions of highly intelligent people who are lulled into a state of sleep by this consciousness bomb of television which is constantly being beamed at them, and who are not allowed to explore the mysteries of their own consciousness using the techniques of shamans that shamans have developed for thousands of years, using the plant hallucinogens. We are simply not allowed to do that, and if we do that, then we are considered to be criminals and we are stigmatized by our society and we are put in prison. This is a reversion to the world of the Spanish Inquisition. If I, as an individual, am not sovereign over my own consciousness, if I cannot decide what to do with my consciousness, which is the heart of my being, then I am not free. And I need not talk about freedom or living in a free society or such issues as democracy if my society will not allow me to explore my own consciousness. And that is the problem that we live in today, that our societies hate the idea of exploring altered states of consciousness and use every power structure that they have to prevent that from happening. If in an altered state of consciousness, my behavior is disruptive in the public arena, then that behavior should rightly be controlled by society. But a personal and private exploration of our own consciousness is our own business, in my view, and is not the business of the state.